a way to kick off the grand finals. My goodness, I'm all hot and bothered.
Golden Boy, Potter, Mitch, man, there's no better way you could start this off. Kick things off in the grand finals of Masters 2. An overtime map on map number 1. And this was off how good Fnatic looked here on the attacker side. I did want to mention that on that intro before we got into that map. Bringing out of the sky, what can they do? Can they keep the jet? And I think they used that perfectly. The way that you actually had the sky flashes to come out to enable Durka to just run not only behind Trailblazers, flashes, and the Seekers, but it enabled him to also create that space, get the first Bloods when they could on the attacker side, and also allow the rest of Fnatic to really move in together right after that. So I think they played a perfect attacker side too, but there had to have been a lot of highlight plays for Sentinels to be able to pull that off. I think they lost a bit of that drive whenever they had that tech pause. And Fnatic just took advantage of that and just ran with it. So you have to be careful with that right now, right? It's been a sweaty first map. It's been stressful for Sentinels, where it's a map that they're supposed to win quite easily. But now you get into map 2, where it's technically Fnatic's playground.
Yeah, and it's very clear that Fnatic are in the heads of Sentinels here, because everyone said, we joke about the script or whatever, but, you know, conventional thinking will have you believe that Sentinels should have walked away fairly handedly, given the results that we've seen in the past of split for Fnatic. This should have been a decisive Sentinels victory. Instead, it goes down to OT. They're struggling to pull up the win. They do so in the end. That's what matters for those guys. They get one on the board, but